Okay, so after the long stint last time, I got a number of items. I gotta do shaders, export file names. Let's have a quick look at that. I'm pretty sure it's just because it's hard coded, and that's because I don't actually have the source information along with me at the moment when I do this, which is unfortunate. Okay. I'm not going to tackle that quite yet. What else do I have to do? I probably need to sort out like the all this nonsense really. As well as start putting things into subdirectories. Okay, first of all, let's make sure. These are all the same, right? Yeah. So I was to move these. What's wrong with these guys? These guys. Oh yeah, they have the incorrect spurvy. So let's not write those guys out quite yet. Let's see if we can actually remove them. Do 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 do. Data E resources. Da, 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 da. Okay, these guys. Bam. Goodbye. Right. That still loads fine. Right. And the stuff that's added down here is old garbage that I don't want to see. Goodbye. So, okay, let's see if who else is currently using the new ones. Do I need this here anymore? Bone mesh vertex descriptor. Or is it using the one up here? So, to figure that out. Let's find an application. Oh no, only one is using this, and it's just the shader loader. Everyone else is still using the old style. The index stem. Well, get out of the way. Out of the way. Goodbye. Index stem. Okay. We're gonna do this, so we're gonna change up, what was it, vertex descriptor or material loader? Let's just do this one first. Let's do that, and we return this instead. Fantastic stuff here. Okay. ID, info, resource ID, vertex descriptor, loader. So this is going to be a bunch of more busy work for like last time, unfortunately. And that. All right. Import function. Then it doesn't take in this. It's the get ID. That's already changed over to the faux resource ID. So that's safe. Slowly builds. Okay, that's looking good so far. Then we'll want to do the same thing for the materials. Material loader. Like that. And it's that. I should really change from Make Fast to Ninja. Ninja is faster. It doesn't have this extra make nonsense going on. Okay. So the idea here is I get rid of those, it's going to run with the thing. I shouldn't have exited that way, but whatever. Next, I want to get rid of these vertex descriptors. So I'm going to take the vertex descriptors and materials and move them to that directory. So material, material, VD, VD, VD. Actually, no. First of all, get rid of the shader. Shader, 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 shader. Only four shaders? 5, 6, 7. There they are. Move them to, I don't know. Here for the moment. Move them. Still good, right? These shaders are no longer wanted. What very fun nonsense. Okay. Clear these guys out. Goodbye. Oh, crap. I shouldn't have used that. It's so slow. Okay. Oh, come on. I should have just used the git revert. There we go. Okay. These guys are deleted. That's correct. Don't want this either. Correct. So delete that file. Revert these guys. Correct. Okay. Now we move the material, vertex, material, material, vertex, vertex. Move them out to here. Okay. And there's an extra. No, that was just the mesh. That's deliberately out there. And these other guys are still down here, so let's do this data start at YAML. It's a bit easier and faster. So we've cleaned that out. All that's left is the mesh BD, which is also sitting down here. Boned mesh. No, that's the vertex descriptor there. I can get rid of these. Root directory, vertex descriptor goes away. Vertex, vertex. So that just kind of leaves the armature and mesh and image, which are the items that get their information from external files right now. Although technically shaders do the same thing. Yeah, okay. At the moment, though, it's getting cleaner. Very slowly. Add these guys. Bam. Okay. Now for the other items, this is a bit more tricky, I think. Actually, is it? Why? Why would this be more tricky? Okay, the export is more tricky because I don't keep a lot of this information around at all. But import should still be easy. So I'll just focus on importing these things right now. Because I believe importing these items are imported from manually in here somewhere. So not here, not here, not you. You test mesh two, and test armature, right? That's it. And then we've got the image. This is brought in from something else. Dang. Okay, so not quite image yet. I can get these other guys. So what do we got? 11. So we'll do like 12, 13, and 14, something like that. We'll have to, well, actually, we'll just add to one right now. We'll just add it to armature. We do that, and then we're going to have to. I need an extra function as well for it. Turn that. Then we got a pool. We need to add the new find. Then we gotta go back to application. Thank you. And this will be, what was it? 12, 11, 12. Like that. Then we gotta update the, well, right now it's still the same, right? Same loader, it's still gonna use this down here. Come on. Okay. So we've got a couple other things we need to do. We need to do index ID equals 12. Editor name is test armature. Need to be able to load these in. Or do I? I need to at least export them, but I don't export these yet because I don't have the information. Okay. Let's just do this instead. Armature, image, vertex, shader. Where's armature? There you are. What? Did I not update this for new function type? I guess I haven't. Is there not? Do I not have like armature? Oh, I don't have a create info type for this yet. Okay. It would basically be just that, right? It's just what? From the loader. It's a string, and then that. Okay, so not quite as easy. Okay, let me just grab a drink real quick. Okay, so back to armature. I need a create info for this. So grab that. We'll just grab it from. Not here. Not there. There. Material armature. Animations. File name root armature node. Okay. And I need to put that before it. Fix that up. We don't need these anymore. This is now. This will be in path now. And then. In this case, we have this. Okay. Go down to Armature Public. Alright, then we come back out. We need to change up the armature loader for this as well, right? That end, okay. That end. Go out to the application. Find the armature loader. It becomes far closer to this. Becomes that instead. And then this. And I can update it to using that as well. Okay, we're in here. Yes. That and passing that function around. This. Okay, now we do this, where we're going to have a look. Preferably, it's going to go all the way up to 12 underscore something or other, and there's an issue with this not existing. You're right. Okay, we're here. We have index of 1 compared to 12, so of course that's not going to work, right? But this will. Nope, we never find it. Interesting. Okay. Why is this? This is probably because I didn't actually rename it to like be 12 underscore 12, right? And then I didn't put it up here with the rest. Very slowly. There it is. Okay, we move it. We've eventually find it now, correct? Yes. Directory entry is path 12 test armature. Go. Amazing. Amazing. Okay. So that's one. Next will be mesh. Let's do mesh next. Well, actually, let's first of all save that. Add that. Clear these guys out. Go into application. Remove the exports for the moment because they're just annoying me now. Let's add all that. Next will be mesh. Let's get the meshes done. So let's start here. Here. Pool. Ah, yes, the function. Okay, we got the pool, we got that, we gotta do modifications to the loader now. So, well, let's do it. Well, first of all, actually, let's figure out the IDs that we're going to give it. So we have 12, leaves 13 and 14. These up. Up, 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 up. Come on. Up to here. This is a vertex descriptor, not a mesh. Why is this here? Get rid of that, please. Application. We're updating the this to be just like that one. Actually, that's another thing. I need the create info for the mesh, whatever that may be. Close others. What is it? It's just that. All right, well, we'll just have a struct of just that then. And what is this supposed to be? It's a mesh create info inside a unique pointer. Oh, good job. I played myself. Okay. Where is this? Even like exist. Is it part of loader? Yeah, it is. What is this? This is the different types of meshes. Okay. Well, I had a thing earlier where it was like faux mesh source, so that's what I'm going to do here. So we're going to rename all those. File source. Okay, then up here we become it's going to become this. That also unfortunately means that these guys need to be here as well, because unique pointer needs to have the declaration there, not just a for declaration. Ew. I will say ew to that. I like this memory type less and less every day. I really do. Okay. Becomes that. And it becomes that. Create info. We go inside of there. dot mesh source, or I should just call it like source, really. Yep. Okay. File system path. Okay, that's mesh converted. Now I got the loader. Need the. This is going to become. Okay, we come down here, then we have and then finally down in the application, we convert over the search mechanism. To this image loader, mesh loader. Okay, like that. Do that. I need to add side note, test mesh 2. Okay, let's see what's about to happen here. It works just fine. Okay, that literally only leaves images, the image, which will be 15. Before I do anything else, save that, make sure it runs. Of course it does. Oh, there's a lot of stuff there. So images, image, 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 image. Here we are. Yeah, okay. I need to move. Oh my God, hold on, let me write this down. Do that. Move YAML file parsing, actually. File from resource lib. Eventually, I just want to convert the resource YAML lib to just be like the actual, like these, the declarations and definitions, much like I have for the Vulkan types up here. Yeah. Like this. This is what's exposed. The searching for and reading of the file should be something that's outside of the domain of the resource library. But first, images, image, 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 image. Finish up image. So I need a which would have been close these guys, close that, close that, close that. Change this up to full resource ID, ID, comma, that. Oh, and I need to. Names from resources. Okay, pool. Down image pool. Same dealio here. That means now I need to go to the image. Did I actually already rename it? I think I did. And I moved it up here, right? Nope. Where is it? Where to go? Did I just... I killed it. Somehow I lost it. Good job, me. Oh no, it's still here. Oh my god, I'm blind. 15. That. Okay, here we go. Image loader. We're here. We're going to do this. These two, that's good. We're going to pass through the image to this, so it'll be... We go down to image.cpp. Sorry, public. There we go. Leaves image thing in here. It's a standard string, which is the file name. That just leaves going back down to image loader. Down here somewhere. There it is. Right, missing something. It'll be this. Yeah, of course. This is a material, right? So I need to change it up to be taking in... Nope. Nope. Yes. Takes in that type, it's material. So if we go back down to material, we're going to have to modify taking in a string. Hold on. It's already taken a frag. It's still taking in frag descriptor name. That's wrong. No, maybe not. Yeah, that should actually go all the way down and back perfectly fine. I just need to make sure, yeah. Okay, one thing I do need to do is okay, and that just leaves the application, changing that up for one of these. Okay. Got all of that. The changeover from text-based to image or number, numerical-based resourcing. Groups kind of half there, but not really. Okay. With a pretty easy shortcut back and forth. I mean, right now it's not subdirectory or anything like that yet. Aye. Application. This has grown massively. Right? Just yet, large chunks. Extra nearly 400, 350 lines or so. Not great. Not great at all. Plus additions for this stuff. Is this actually still required? Because did it not change the vertex descriptors? Vertex shader 8, 6, something like that. Okay. So if I was to, let's say, change out the application right now for, what do I call them? Vertex descriptor 2 is actually what? 0. Material 2 is currently 4. Non-boned VD is currently 1. Mesh material is 5. Mesh pool test mesh is 13. Test armature is 12. Okay. And then going down for the others, vertex descriptor is 0. Material 2 is 4. Boned mesh VD is 2. That's 5. 13. 12. Okay, that should mean that I no longer require some of these to be added. The shaders specifically. No, no, not at all. Oh, I can't add it because I have a blank name on it right now. Okay. So not quite there, because blank names means it's a non-unique resource, and thus a no-go. So I need to fix up the pools for that. Okay, what I'm going to do first of all right now is I'm just going to just put all these guys in as they sit right now, all the resource stuff. Or hold on, does this have... What, this is just formatting. Not really useful, not really useful yet. Yeah. Okay, we'll just get all this stuff. Okay, this part, let's hope that this part still works at this point. Yeah, great. So let's undo that. Let's update these. Resource stuff. To be just O strings. Okay, first iteration of that. So we've got some stuff in, so that kind of reduces the load here for the moment. This is just what? This is just that. Okay, I don't really care. This is something I'll be for later. Then hold on, state YAML. I don't care about this then. Okay. So let's go through the pools. At this point, we're going to have to go through the pools, and we're going to make sure that the we have to change from the uniqueness being based on the string to being on the ID. So, where are we? Don't need this. Don't need this. I don't even know why this is still open. Start with this. We're adding. Okay. Okay. That didn't break anything, right? Oh crap. I need to also make sure it's unique across all resource types. Or I would only really have to do that in debug dev mode. I shouldn't have to do that real in the release. Let's assume the data is good. If it's not good, then we got problems. Different problems anyways. It should be workable technically, but I'm not gonna like it. Anyways, see if we can get rid of these now, which are based on something else entirely now. Okay. Get rid of that. Great. Is quick to work with and just it just is. Okay, it just is. I don't care. So that's another part done. We got rid of some stuff. Let's restage. So that means what else? Split names from resources. Move YAML files. Okay. I mean, technically, these can all be blank now, right? Because it's all based on IDs. Yep. Okay. Now I want to split the what I'm now calling editor IDs out from here. just something else entirely. Which, okay, I only really need editor IDs during dev mode. I don't need them to be available for the final application, as far as I can think. I'm just, like, not really. I really can't, so it could be a separate, collection of, it could be stored separately from the resources. And then the same thing would also apply for the entities. They don't need to have it at runtime, or at production time, or whatever I'm calling it. Simulation time, there we go. Dev time and simulation time. At simulation time, I don't need to have the editor IDs loaded into the application. Those are designed for development purposes, for making entities far more human-readable or organizable or whatever, searchable, than just numbers. So I can keep this as a separate thing that I only load in for specific something or others, whatever. Okay. Editor something editor map. I can call it the editor ID map. Okay, editor ID map, how are we going to organize this? Do I want to like a dual map? Okay. Which way does it go? Editor and the file resource ID. Editor to resource ID, and then we'd also need a similar Realistically, while I could allow the same name for both a resource and an entity, since they are separated, that's just probably going to cause more confusion down the line when a name pops up in both sets. Besides, why would they overlap? It's best just to keep it as unique as possible, really. No nonsense, funny business. We may actually want to also double this up so we can have a map going both ways for extra speedy something or other. Okay, then I just need some, like, add. So I need a, I need a function of find. I need to add, I need to update, and I need to remove each of them, I think. Yeah, okay. I have to go both ways. Ooh, that's actually true. When I return, I'd have to return like a list of both resource IDs and entity IDs which match. Okay, we'll just have some resource. Let's try to keep it as simple as possible. Minimal surface of nonsense. Technically, editor name. If I just have it as string, then I could just move the string. Update will basically work the same way. And same thing with remove, really, except it's always going to be based on the ID, not the actual name. Entities first. All this just to get rid of the editor names from individual items, resources. Oh, it's broken. Clang D's decided to save it. Open the folder, thank you. Entity. I can't do it because they're using the exact same type right now. Wah wah. Okay, so this is a read-only operation, so what is it? Really? You can do that. You can do that. I'm sure you can. Just believe. If it doesn't equal the end, first, it'll be second. Okay. And we do the basically the almost the same thing. Except it's the other way around. Oh, I also need to return if it even exists. Like, right now, I'm not even, like, At least on these ones, I can do that, but on the other one, not so much. Because it can probably exist entities that don't have names, like especially those that are generated as part of the simulation, which would then fail on this. Well, does it really matter if it has, if it's empty, that either means the entity doesn't exist? You should already know whether or not it exists. Okay, so I'm not going to actually care. Resource. Okay, we're adding. That means to Normalize to group ID. Do I not have a... I thought I had a toString for this. There you are. Otherwise, we do this scoped lock, and then we got to go through if. Realistically, I should be returning a whole bunch of different error codes in the future. If we manage to get through all these, then entity to editor, basic entity. Then, of course, I have to do the same checks on these other ones. Okay. I really should just, you know what? No, I'm not going to agonize over it. I'm going to actually just put it in place right now. Resource equals foe, invalid resource. Okay. Maybe I can remove by string. No. If you want to remove an entity from this, you must already have the string and it attached to the entity. No, just like randomly going through and searching and deleting things that way. Programmatically, anyways. We just do this. Couldn't find it because it's at the end. They would just say foe log general info. Otherwise, you remove them. Can I just like, iterator position? I could just do it by key. So no, I can't do that. I need to first of all remove it from editor anti.erase by the search iterator second. Use that and remove them. Okay. Now for updating. Scope lock. You cannot if, okay, if editor name is empty. Otherwise, basically need to do the same thing as this. So if I update, it'll just be become, sorry, editor to entity equals, ooh. So what I'd have to do first is erase this one. Equals that. So hold on. Editor to entity, we erase it, then we add the new one. No, it's the other way around, isn't it? String, then the entity. First of all, I need to make sure it doesn't exist. Actually, no, if I already have that. Editor the resource, edit to entity. Do the same thing up here, down here. CDEF. Oh, good. Where does... Is this why you keep crashing? All right. Well, it builds, right? It builds. I'm going to call it there. I'm going to fix whatever the hell this clang D problem is and just carry on with the editor name splitting next time. Cheers.